We might want to come in and just adjust the mask in some cases. So as you can see right here, we have the mask. And it might not even be that obvious. It might be just enough because we have a lot going on. But we can just start here, bring up the mask path. And we'll just click on the stopwatch at this point. And we can just come in and start manipulating that mask just by moving these points where we feel like they should go, especially in the foreground elements here. And again, there are other ways you can go about doing these types of things, but for right now, we're just going to do something like this since it's relatively simple compared to what else we could be doing since it's such a simple scene. And that's looking pretty good. Again, you can adjust these things. It doesn't have to be exact. But then he's going to jump over here. And at that point, we might want to move it. But actually, I would say not much. We can just come right about here and just kind of move it up in relation to that rock. And we could even come down like this a little bit for that one to cover the tree. All the way in that background. So kind of like that. And then it's going to just move over like this. And at this point, when the camera stops, because we have it come right here, I'm going to copy and paste my first keyframe for my mask back to there. So it kind of looks like this. Now, it might not be perfect, but what I am going to do, just so I can test this out, is back up to that first keyframe where I started the mask path and then come down here to this mask right here for its path. And I'm going to insert keyframe and then paste those keyframes. So now both of those masks will follow the same path and hopefully everything is going to look pretty good.
Full chapter 2 is linked below.